Professor Dr. R. Venkata Rao is a pillar of quality legal education in India and has previously served as the Vice Chancellor of NLSIU Bangalore for 10 years. Professor Rao has authored and edited several books and published over 100 papers. He has successfully guided many LLM and PhD scholars and has over 4 decades of teaching and research experience. I now request Professor Dr. R. Venkata Rao, Chairperson, VSLLS and VSES WIPS, to give the opening address.
Dr. S. C. Watser, the rising star, the Vice Chairman, Mr. Sunit Vats, Professor Subba Rao, Dean Rashmi, Dean Shilpa, distinguished colleagues, esteemed parents, and fellow students. As to why I am addressing you as fellow students, I will tell you later. When I see the bright sunny morning on the occasion of this meeting in the open space, I was telling our chairman, sir, it is wonderful on the part of the organizers to have arranged a meeting in the open space because it sends a clear signal to our little angels, the 21st century hopes of this great country, our first year students, that they should always have their minds open. Young friends, please remember, 3 things work out the best when they are open. As you know, the parachute works out the best when it is open. Books work out the best when they are open. Most of us, we purchase the books, never open it, and keep them as a decorative item for the visitors. The third one is human mind. Human mind works out the best. Therefore, it's a symbolic gesture that our mind should be kept open when we have arranged the meeting in the open space. My grateful thanks to the organizers, sir. Hearty congratulations to all of you for having taken the wisest decision in getting admitted into the stream of education which will ordain you with constitutional responsibilities. And I would say this is the best gift that the months of October and November can give you. As you know, November is a holy month, not because we celebrate Diwali, not because we celebrate Chhath Puja tomorrow, but 3 important events have happened in the month of November. I will start with 26th November, which is celebrated on the Constitution Day, when the Constitution of India was adopted. Then today, 9th November, is Legal Services Day. Way back in 1995, we had a very important legislation. But apart from these two, a globe-shattering incident had happened in 1989 on 9th November, which made the world to celebrate this day as World Freedom Day. In 1989, on 9th November, the Berlin Wall collapsed and the world is commemorating that as the World Freedom Day so that no wall will separate people in future. Therefore, young minds, please remember when we are celebrating World Freedom Day today, you must understand that we are here to demolish the walls and build bridges. Bridges of friendship, bridges of fraternity, bridges of oneness. So that ultimately speaking, we have the concept of Vasudhaivika Kutumbikam. And before I speak to you about the orientation, let me first bow down my head in reverence before your parents, whose sacrifices are primarily responsible for keeping you here this morning. In fact, you should remember the contribution of 3 mothers in your life. You should never forget. First is the biological mother who has given birth to you. Rabindranath Tagore said, God created mother maybe because he cannot be present everywhere. If biological mother has given birth to us, our foster mother, alma mater, Vivekananda School of Law and Legal Studies, Vivekananda Institute of Professional Studies, would enable us to stand on our feet. And from today onwards, the world will recognize you by your status as a student of WIPS, as a student of VSL and LS. And therefore, we should never let down the second mother, alma mater, or foster mother. The third mother, you have the national flag fluttering high there. What do you mean by Azadi Ki Amrit Mahotsav we are celebrating this year? Jawaharlal Nehru long ago said, who cares whether you live or die if India dies? Who dies if India lives, and who lives if India dies? Therefore, these three mothers, you should never let them down. Biological mother who has given you the birth, alma mater, which would enable you to stand on your feet, and Mother India, especially as lawyers in the making. Remember, you must understand that it was lawyers who provided the intellectual front arm to the freedom movement. And more than two-thirds of the members of the Constituent Assembly were lawyers. And now I will tell you as to why I have addressed you as fellow students. Now, I call you as fellow students, don't accuse me of originality. I have borrowed that phrase from the greatest lawyer that this country has produced, Nani Palkhiwala. Most of you must have heard his name. And Nani Palkhiwala was the person who argued the case in case one of the Bharati's case, which ultimately gave us the basic structure doctrine. And he argued so brilliantly in the Supreme Court. When the arguments were going on, two Supreme Court judges off the cuff, they said, how tragic it is, how unfortunate it is that only the judgments of the Supreme Court are recorded and published, but not the brilliant arguments of the advocates. How much the younger generation is missing by not recording the arguments of the brilliant advocates. We only look forward to the day when arguments of advocates like Palkhiwala will be recorded and preserved for posterity. And that Palkhiwala, immediately after Keshavananda Bharati's case, was invited to address Ferguson College students in Pune. Pune is his native place. And to the same function, three Supreme Court judges before whom he argued in Keshavananda Bharati's were also invited. And Palkhiwala addressed their lordships, and then he said, fellow students, immediately one of the Supreme Court judges said, Nani, you have argued so brilliantly before us the other day, and today you are calling them fellow students. Are you a student? Then you know what Palkhiwala said? Yes, my lord, I mean what I say. Then beautifully he said, you must remember that today, a young person, when he is on the rolls of a law college, when he is on the rolls of a law school, he will be a law student. But when he walks from the law school, from the university to the universe, this law student will become a student of law throughout his life. And learning is a process which must start in the womb of your mother and travel beyond your respective tombs, he said. And then he said, my lord, today if I have a matter to argue, you know, Palkhiwala was such a brilliant advocate. Not only was he a brilliant advocate, he was a man of humility. Even when he became a top advocate, he never felt infradig to argue before a trial court. At the ripe old age of 80, he used to argue in Munsif Magistrates Courts and the Sessions Courts. And because he said there is no distinction between the Supreme Court and the Magistrate Court, all the courts perform the same function. And he said, my lord, today if I have a matter to argue before a magistrate court, at 10:30 in the morning, my trousers would be trembling like a first-year student of law appearing for the first moot court competition. And the day on which my trousers stop trembling, I will quit my profession, he said. In that sense, I am a fellow student of the young minds. And therefore, I have addressed you as fellow students. I have congratulated you because, please remember, legal profession is the only profession to be mentioned in the Constitution of India. No other profession is mentioned in 395 articles and full schedules. Therefore, you are now entering a stream of education which will clothe you with constitutionally ordained responsibilities. That is the reason why on the day of admissions, a copy of the preamble was given to you. I'm sure you must have got it. Now, this was given to you so that this would be kept as a constant companion. This must be close to your heart. As our former President of India, Pranab Mukherjee, said, whatever you do in your life hereafter, the Constitution of India must be at the back of your mind and at the center of your heart. Remember. And today, take a pledge that the preambular aspirations and the fundamental duties would become a part of your flesh, your bones, your body, and your soul. Because no text contains such distilled wisdom as the preamble of the Constitution. Remember, justice, liberty, equality, fraternity, I need not tell you, and the 10 commandments of fundamental duties. Therefore, today, remember, it is our pious obligation to exhort you to make Constitution a part of your body and soul. The next point I wanted to tell you is, please remember, legal profession is called a learned profession not because you are required to display learning, it is only incidental, but you are required to show the highest conduct, which is corollary to and consequence of that learning. Therefore, WIPS is one institution which focuses on character building, which focuses on conduct. And in this context, I will tell you, the former Chief Justice of the Supreme Court of the United States, Errol Warren, was once asked a question. Sir, whom would you like to appoint as judges? You know what he replied? He smiled and said, a good human being who also knows a bit of law. He said, we would like to appoint a good human being who also knows a bit of law. This is one institution which unstintedly, remember, works day in and day out to make you good human beings. So that one of the fundamental duties mentioned in the Constitution of India, to strive towards excellence in all spheres of individual and collective activity, so that the nation constantly rises to higher levels of achievement, would be achieved. Here, let me tell you, excellence means it is not only excellence in the product, but excellence in the human being. Because we believe that academic excellence without human excellence is disastrous. And this orientation program is meant to drive home one particular point that, remember, you must have two goals in your life as a student of law. Number one, compassion for whom you do and passion for what you do. Today is Legal Services Day, remember, where we have an obligation upon us to help the unfortunate and hapless people. Therefore, take a pledge today on the first day in your law school that you will devote all your might to help the hapless so that surroundings around us would be safe and secure. That is the primary objective of the orientation program. And as youngsters, when I was a first year student of law, when I was attending a similar orientation program, I was raising my eyebrows, looking at the mountain to be scaled. Immediately, I still remember, the Chief Justice of the High Court of Orissa, Gautakrishna Patra, said, young man, the any orientation program is arranged to remove the pebbles in your shoes so that you can start climbing. Because it's not the height of the mountain that is worrisome. It's not the height of the mountain that is troublesome. It is the pebble in your shoes. Therefore, remove your pebble in your shoes. Start scaling the mountain without looking at the top. And keep constitution close to your heart. And let me assure you, from the Honorable Chairman, sir, down to the foot soldier at the micro level, no hour would be ungodly for us to help you, because you are the future of the country. And I pray the Almighty to make your sojourn in WIPS fruitful, successful, assuring you of all our guidance, of all our cooperation. Remember, and as I have told you, we believe only in one dictum, that the sun rises even on Sundays. There is no Sunday for us. Remember. And we also believe in one dictum, that all holidays are holy days. And therefore, for the pursuit of education and for the cause of learning, remember, we'll be there with you, and we wish you all the best. God bless you all. Thank you very much.